Hi dear students, welcome back to Mathematics Online class. Now, let us start the exercise 9.4 based on the homogeneous differential equation. So, in a previous video, people have already come to know that what is a homogeneous differential equation? A differential equation is of the form dy by dx is equal to f of x, y, where f of x, y can be expressed as f of x, y can be expressed as lambda power n into f of x, y. Then this f of x, y can be written as, here we can write lambda x, lambda y. Then this f of x, y is said to be a nth degree homogeneous function. Okay, how to get this one? Replacing x as lambda x, y as lambda y, simplify, and how to get the lambda power n into f of x, y. And this is said to be a nth degree homogeneous function. Or one more method is that. What is that one more method? We can express this x power n into g of y divided by x. This is the nth degree homogeneous function. Or y power n into h of x divided by y. This is also homogeneous function of the degree n. Any of the method you can do it. Okay. Now we are solving only the 0th degree homogeneous function. That means lambda power 0, x power 0 or y power 0. That type of functions or that type of homogeneous function only we are solving. Okay, let us solve. And previously we just taken one particular example. How do you do that? Dy by dx is equal to f of x, y. This f of x, y can be expressed as x power 0 into g of y by x, converting in this manner. Then we are putting y by x is equal to p, y is equal to p into x, differentiating this one with respect to x, dy by dx will replacing into the original equation, y by x as a p, simplifying, integrating, will get the required general solution. That is the solution of the differential equation by the homogeneous method. Already variable separable method, you know that. That method only we are going to apply here. Okay. Let us take the first problem of the exercise. That is x square plus xy into dy is equal to x square plus y square is equal to into dx. X square plus y square into dx. First of all, write in the form of dy by dx. Okay. Dy as it is, dx as is taken, dx is equal to x square plus y square as it is divided by x square plus xy square. Okay, now we need to check whether it is a homogeneous or not. Homogeneous means replacing. First of all, I just consider let f of x, y function in terms of x and y, both variables. X square plus y square plus divided by x square plus x into y. So now what I am just going to do? Replace x as a lambda x and y as a lambda y, where lambda is a non-zero real number. So what we get? F of lambda x comma lambda y is equal to, wherever x is the replace lambda x, wherever y is the replace the lambda y. X square, that means lambda x whole square, can I write that directly? Lambda square x square, similarly lambda square y square, whole thing divided by. Next, what we get? Lambda square x square plus, as it is, lambda x into lambda y, lambda lambda, lambda square, x into y. So numerator lambda square is found. What is that? X square plus y square divided by. Denominator lambda square, taking common. What will get? X square plus x into y. Here lambda square get cancelled. So here we can write this value also. Lambda power 0. Lambda power 0 is nothing but 1. 1 into x square plus y square divided by x square plus xy. That is nothing but f of x, y. So f of lambda x, lambda y can be expressed in the form of lambda power n into f of x, y, where n is equal to 0. That is nothing but 0th degree homogeneous function. Therefore, it is a homogeneous function. F of x, y is a homogeneous function. Is a homogeneous function. Okay, now after getting the homogeneous, they are asking that show that the given differential equation is homogeneous. We have proved it homogeneous. Then, and for each of them, we need to solve the differential equation. How to solve this differential equation? So that is it. I just write one more time. That is dy by dx is equal to x square plus y square divided by x square plus xy square. How to solve this one? For solving this one, already you know the method. That is, put y by x is equal to b. Whenever dy by dx is there, on that time, how to substitute y by x is equal to b. Suppose if it is dx divided by dy by dx, in that case, we need to put that x divided by y as b. Okay, that types of problems are there. We will see later. Okay, now here I am just going to put what I am just going to put means I just call this as equation number 1. Put y by x is equal to b. What happens if I substituted the y by x is equal to b? So y by x is equal to b. What we can write? Differentiate or y is equal to x into b. Y is equal to x into b. I just write here differentiating with respect to x. Differentiating with respect to x. Y differentiation with respect to x is dy by x is equal. Differentiation of x is 1 with respect to x. So p is the plus x keep as it is. Differentiation of p with respect to x, that is dv by dx. Call this as the equation number 2. Substitute the equation number 2 in 1. What happens if I replace the equation number 2 in 1? Equation number 1 we can rewrite. How do we rewrite the equation number 1 is? I just take the here only I just rewrite. How I just rewrite means y by x is required. I need to replace so that I just take the x square is common. If you take an x square is common, what happens? 1 plus y by x, this thing whole square. Are you clear? If you once again multiply the x square into the bracket, we will get the x square plus y square. Whole thing divided by. What we have to make the common? Again, here x square is common. If I take an x square is common, here it is 1 plus as it is. X is already there, but I just take an x square. That means y by x is left. Are you clear? Now call this as the equation number 1. Now, replacing equation number 2 in an equation number 1. Here x square, get the answer. I just run this by. Okay. So what we get? Wherever divided by x is there, divided by x can replace as this one. I just write here. That is b plus x into dv by dx is equal to 1 as it is plus y by x whole square is there. Y square divided by x square can be written as y by x whole square. Y by x is nothing but what? P. So this is 1 plus p square divided by 1 plus y by x, that means 1 plus p. Okay. Here in terms of x and y, I just converted in terms of x and p. Now, simplify this one. This differential equation we need to do by the variable separable method. So, x into dv by dx is equal to 1 plus p square divided by 1 plus p. This p simplified into right hand side minus p. Simplify. Right hand side taking LCM as 1 plus p. 1 plus p square minus p into this bracket minus p square divided by 1 plus p. Okay, now plus p square minus p square get cancelled. 1 minus p divided by 1 plus p. This is x into dv by dx. X into dv by dx. So separate the variable at this moment. So x and dx is the right hand side. Here is 1 plus p divided by 1 minus p into dv is equal to 1 by x into dx. So now all the variables are separated. P variables, p terms are one side, x terms are one side, integrating. Now, what is the integration of 1 plus p divided by 1 minus p with respect to p? Integration of 1 by x into dx is done. Integration of 1 by x, that is standard form, log of x is done. How to integrate this one? It is a proper fraction or improper fraction? Proper and improper. It is improper is that because degree of the numerator function, degree of the denominator function is same. So in this case, how to integrate this one? So I just, several methods are there. First of all, I just subtract the integral 1 divided by 1 minus v. This is one integral into dv plus integration of p divided by 1 minus p into dv is equal to integration of 1 by x into dx. Why is this written like this? Means it is 1 by x form, log of x, you can write it. Coefficient of p or coefficient of the variable is negative, we just divide the negative quantity. Or put 1 by 1 minus p is equal to d, will get the integral. Next, here how will you do? P divided by 1 minus p is there. How to integrate this one? And 1 by x is already there. Then how to integrate p divided by 1 minus p? If you take a substitution, that is also not worth here. For example, I just take it. Or if you can do the substitution, no problem. 1 minus p is equal to t to take on. Or else I just continue here. But okay, no. Differentiate minus dv is equal to dt. So dv can be replaced as what? Minus dt. 1 minus p can be replaced as t. Then after that, p can be written as what? We can write the p. This p can be written as 1 minus p. Then afterwards, what happens? Wherever p is there, replace the 1 minus p. And 1 minus p can be replaced as t. Dt can be replaced. Dv can be replaced as minus dt. Okay, integral. Now here, now we can again simplify. 1 by t minus dt. Minus minus plus t divided by t into dt. T by t is 1. So integration of 1 into t. Are you got my point? Okay, R is divided. Once again, we will get the same answer. Are you sure? So now I just write diagram here. So I think people got it. At the side, we just mentioned that for this integral, put 1 minus v as a t. And differentiate minus dv is equal to dt. Substitution method already know that dv is equal to minus dt. Then v can be written as v can be written as 1 minus t. Are you sure? Then wherever v is there, replace the 1 minus t. And wherever 1 minus t is there, replace the t. Wherever dv is there, replace the minus dv. Right. And this is doing lot work. Integration of 1 minus p as a t, p as a 1 minus t, dv as replaced as a minus dv. I just keep the minus outside integration. Minus is outside. Separate it. Integration of 1 divided by t into dv. Are you sure? We can separate it. This is minus. Integration of t by t. T by t is 1 into dv. Log of it. Okay. Again, here minus into. Integration of 1 by t is log of t minus as it is. Integration of 1 with respect to t is t. Are you sure? Okay. Now, this is for minus signs of log of t. Log of t is nothing but what is the t value? T value is 1 minus p. Next, minus signs of minus into minus plus plus. T is the, what is the t value? 1 minus p. 1 minus p. Okay. So integration of p divided by 1 minus p can be written as minus log of 1 minus p plus 1 minus p. How it becomes means? Based on the substitution method. I am just going to write directly. So this integration is log of mod of 1 minus p. But variable coefficient is negative is there, so that divide by the minus 1. Already you know that if the coefficient of the x is any other number, non-zero number, we have to divide in the integration. Or else we have to do the substitution method. Okay, plus as it is. Integration of p divided by 1 minus p divided by 1 minus p integration is here. What is that? That is minus times of log of 1 minus p plus just a 1 minus p. This integration is over. Is equal to integration of 1 by x is log of mod of x plus x. Okay, now continue. I just simplify the remaining part on the right hand side. Just check it. What will get? Okay. So this is minus is that. I just write log of minus, you can write multiply. This minus taken to the here. That means 1 minus 3 whole power minus 1. Minus log of 1 minus 3 is the plus 1 minus 3 is equal to log of mod x plus c is the. I just combine. How I just combine? This is, we can write log of 1 divided by 1 minus 3 minus log of 1 minus 3 plus just a 1 minus 3 is equal to log of mod x plus c is the. Log a minus log b. Log a minus log b. What is the log a minus log b? Log a minus log b is nothing but log of a by b. So log of a 1 divided by 1 minus b. Divided by 1 minus b is nothing but if it becomes a product. So this is 1 minus b equals plus 1 minus b is equal to log of mod of x plus c. Okay. Now at this moment replace the p. If you replace the p, what will you get? Because the given question in terms of x and y is there. What is this result in terms of p and x? So that replace the p. What is the p? P is nothing but again you can simplify. How to simplify? Log x is taken to left hand side. Log of 1 divided by 1 minus p whole square. This is minus log of mod x plus 1 minus b is equal to c. So log m minus log m, again log of m by m. Log of m by m is nothing but 1 minus b whole square into x plus 1 minus b plus is equal to c. Replacing the p, what will get replacing the p? Log of 1 divided by 1 minus. What is the p? P is y by x. So y by x whole square into x plus 1 minus y by x is equal to. Now remaining part is just a simplification part is. Okay. Log of. Here x is the LCM. One of the x they cancel. 1 x is comes numerator. X square minus. Sorry. X minus y whole square divided by x square. X square, x square, x can cancel. 1x is left. Take on the numerator. Plus x minus y divided by x is equal to c. Keep this much as the solution. Now, again you can simplify. How to simplify this piece? This x minus y divided by x is the little right hand side. Log is eliminating. So e power it will come. We can simplify further. So not necessary. We can keep this much as the answer. So this is how we have to solve the differential equation by the method of homogeneous. Very simple thing is that first of all, the given differential equation, consider the dy by dx is equal to whatever the function is there. In a previously variable separable method, you need to express f of x comma y as a product of the x terms, y terms. Here x and y terms are there, so that is replacing x as a lambda x, y as a lambda y, then we have to express in the form of f of lambda x comma lambda y as lambda power 0 into f of x comma y. Then the given function, it gives the 0th degree homogeneous function. First thing is over, we have shown the homogeneous function. Laterwards, we need to conclude that given differential equation is homogeneous differential equation. Next, so after that, solution and solve each of them is that. Solve is nothing but in this case, whenever dy by dx is given, so dy by dx, we can give that, we can remember the hint. If they given a dy by dx means y divided by x is the. Are you sure? So put y by x is equal to v. Just take a hint. Record my point. Dy by dx means put y by x is equal to v. Then cross multiply, differentiate, and dy by dx will get it. That dy by dx replacing into the equation number 1, original differential equation, simplifying integration part is that. How to integrate means again the variable separable method. Already used to the several problems of the variable separable method. And remaining thing after differentiating y by x is equal to p, replacing variable separable method, integration is that. Already know the basic integration, all the formulas you can easily deal the problem. Okay.
the same manner. Go to the next problem.
The exercise, x minus y into d1 minus x plus y into dx is equal to 0. We need to show that this differential equation is homogeneous. Okay, first of all, try to get the dy by dx. How we get the dy by dx? First of all, I just sit the negative quantity to the right hand side. X minus y into dy is equal to x plus y into dx. Dx is taken to left hand side. What will get? Dy by dx is equal to x plus y divided by x minus. I just call this is the equation number 1. Here, consider f of x comma y. What is f of x comma y? X plus y divided by x minus y itself. Okay, now we need to prove that f of x comma y as the homogeneous. So that replacing x as a lambda x, y as a lambda y. What happens? Lambda x plus lambda y divided by lambda x minus lambda y. Numerator lambda is common, x plus y. Denominator also lambda is common, x minus y. Lambda lambda get cancelled. So x plus y divided by x minus y. What is that? That is the f of x comma y. So lambda power 0 is there. So we got that lambda f of lambda x comma lambda y is equal to lambda power 0 into f of x comma y, which means that f of x comma y is a homogeneous function. F of x comma y is a homogeneous function means a given differential equation is homogeneous. Homogeneous function, therefore the given differential equation is homogeneous. Now, I just rewrite. How I just rewrite? Dy by dx is equal to. I just take here dy by dx is equal. So that what we need to take the common? X is common because I need to get the y by x. Y by x. 1 plus y by x. Denominator also x is common. 1 minus y by x. Okay. So here x get cancelled. 1 plus y by x divided by 1 minus y by x. 1 plus y by x divided by 1 minus y by x. Now, here we can call this as the equation number 1. No need to mention this is the equation number 1 for here. Okay. Now, after that, we need to solve here. For the solution, we need to go for the solution. What is the solution? Put y by x is equal to b. That means y is equal to x into b. Differentiating with respect to x. Differentiating with respect to x. What we get? Differentiation of y with respect to x is dy by dx is equal. You can pause the video, try to solve it. Differentiation of x with respect to x is 1. Second function as it is. Product rule. First function x as it is. Differentiation of phi with respect to x is dv by dx. Okay. Call this as equation number 2. Substituting the equation number 2 in 1. Substituting equation number 2 in 1. What happens? Dy by dx can be replaced as this one. That is p plus x into dv by dx is equal to 1 as it is y by x as a p. 1 minus y by x as a p. So 1 minus p. Now simplify and get the answer. How will you solve? Sit the p into right hand side. First of all, dv by dx is equal to 1 plus p minus p divided by 1 minus p. Taking 1 minus p as the LCM. X into dv by dx. 1 plus p minus p into this bucket. Minus p minus minus plus p square. Divided by 1 minus p. So plus p minus p get cancelled. Remaining thing. X into dv by dx is equal to 1 plus p square divided by 1 minus p. Now, after simplifying this one, first of all, put this y by x is equal to b, differentiate dy by dx, replace this dy by dx into here, y by x as b. Simplify that, how much it is possible, directly simplify. After simplification, variables of double method. Each and every problem is the same method. In a general thing also, you people have taken. So, same method is the same process, only the function is changing. Which value is changing? Only the f of x is f of x comma y changing. Depending upon the f of x comma y, we have to simplify. Okay. Now onwards, variable separable method. That's all. Okay. What we just keep dv is left hand side. So 1 minus v divided by 1 plus v square into dv is equal to x is total into right hand side into dx. Always here one more thing you can remember. Always right hand side 1 by x into dx only will get it. Because this is common thing. X into dv by dx, x into dv by dx. Every problem carries the same thing. So always right hand side 1 by x into dx will be left. Only thing the left hand side. Only thing the v terms we have to simplify. Okay. Mass is this much of simplicity is there. Okay, now. Integrating now. How to integrate 1 minus v divided by 1 plus v square. So again, I just multiply or taking minus. Multiplying by minus 1 on both sides. V minus 1 divided by v square plus 1 into dv is equal to minus 1 by x into dx. Integration. However, you just do the integration. Whatever the method you can do. Here we can apply that. Px plus 2 divided by ax square plus bx plus v. That method we can do it. Or else the substitution method is worked out. That method also you can do it. Whatever. So I am just trying to convert f dash of x divided by f of x. Already the standard integration, we know that. How to convert the f dash of x into f of x? f dash of x divided by f of x is nothing but again the same thing. Integration of bx plus 2 divided by ax square plus bx plus c. Because the bx plus 2 is equal to, you used to write that. Px plus 2 is equal to a into b by dx of ax square plus bx plus c plus capital B. We need to find the a and b value. Instead of applying this method, directly I am just converting. Because that much of simplicity and that many problems you have already solved, so that directly you can convert easily. So that how to convert in this form, f dash of x divided by f of x. Suppose you will differentiate the denominator term, what will get? 2v will get. Element of integration is dv is that. So 2v will get. So numerator we have to get the 2 into v. How to get the 2 into v? But here is not a 2. Multiplying divided by 2. Divided by 2 as it is 2 into v is left divided by v square plus 1. Are you clear? But minus 2 is done into dv. Minus 2 into, are you clear? Minus 2 divided by v square plus 1 into dv. Are you well clear? We can split the two integrals. v square plus 1 as it is 2v minus 2. 2 is common. 2 common, v minus 1. Again the same thing, 2 to get cancelled. Are you clear? Okay. Is equal to minus 1 by x into dx. Check it. After very simplification, if you go back, reverse, will you get the same thing or not? 2 is common, 2 to get cancelled, 3 is left, minus 1 is left, v minus 1 divided by v square plus. Yes. Okay, now this is f dash of x divided by f of x. This integral is over. And one more thing. This 1 by 2 is product with both the terms. So that as is right, here also 1 by 2. Are you clear? Here 2 to get cancelled, here also 2 to get cancelled, p minus 1. Okay. So now, and don't forget it, if you forget to write the 1 by 2, then the next answer will be wrong. You will get the mistake. So after this much, that means you can get the maximum 2 or 3 marks out of the 5 marks. Okay. Now, this integration is f dash of x divided by f of x. This integration, 1 divided by v square plus 1. Already know the integration of 1 divided by a square plus x square, or x square plus a square. What is the integration of 1 divided by x square plus a square? That means 1 by a into tan inverse of xy. You know that integration of 1 divided by x square plus 1 is tan inverse of x by 1 or tan inverse of x, tan inverse of x, but in place of 1, a square is there. So that 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a, standard formula. Okay, This is also converted into this form. This is the tan inverse of x by 1 by 8. Then that is the required answer. What we get? 1 by 2 into 2. This is log of p square plus 1, log of f of x minus 1 by 2 into 2. So 1 by
here, once again.
Okay, 1 by 2, here we use 2, 2 by 2, okay, 1 by a into, it is p square plus 1 is that, p square plus 1 is nothing but tan inverse of p is equal to minus log of mod of x plus c. Here put to get the answer, remaining thing, log of this 1 by 2 log of p square plus 1 is that, in fact this is log of root of p square plus 1, because 1 by 2 is taken here, p square plus 1 over 1 by 2, over 1 by 2 is nothing but square root, minus tan inverse of p is equal to minus log of mod x plus c. Now I just continue on that side.
Just the simplification part is that you can easily simplify the things.
How to simplify? So replace the p term here. What is the p? Log of square root is the square root of p is nothing but what? Y by x. So y square plus x square, outside the x square is outside the square root, there is nothing but x. Okay, next I got this one. Y square by x square, x square is LCM, y square plus x square, root is that, outside the root, root of x square is x, okay, minus tan inverse of y by x is equal to minus log of mod x plus c, log term given to left hand side, log of root of y square plus x square divided by x plus log of mod x is equal to tan inverse of y by x plus c. Log m minus log m plus log n. Log m plus log n is log of m n. Log of m n is nothing but root of y square plus x square divided by x into x. Here x x will cancel. Tan inverse of y by x plus c. Here log of root of y square plus x square or x square plus y square is equal to tan inverse of y by x plus c. This is the required solution. This is the required general solution. How many arbitrary constants are there? Only the one arbitrary constant, because it is a first order differential equation. How many? What is the order of the differential equation? That many number of arbitrary constants will be present in the solution of the differential equation. So here only one arbitrary constant, first order. First order means only one arbitrary constant we have to get it. Okay, this is the required solution. Further, you can simplify. How you can simplify? We have to eliminate the log, means root of y square plus x square is equal to e power tan inverse of y by x plus c. Instead of the c, I just write it as the c1. We can stop at here. For your convenience, I am just simplifying further c1. Okay, it is a c1. Then root of y square plus x square is equal to e power tan inverse of y by x into e power c1. Loss of indices, a power m plus n, a power m into a power n, that matters. E power c1 can be written as, so root of y square plus x square is equal to e power tan inverse of y by x into c, where c is equal to, what is the c? C is equal to e power c1. So now again we can take the square root on both sides, or else keep as it is. Either this is the solution or this is the solution. If you are familiar with this much only, you can write it. No need to write this one. You will get the full marks. Okay. This is how we have to solve the homogeneous differential equation. Here lengthy problems are there, no issue, but the process is common process. You can easily solve this problem around 4 to 5 minutes, or maximum 6 minutes. You can make the fixed time, keep the watch and count down the time, because in the examination you need to base this type of problems. So that reason in the part B. So that reason
So better to check the time while practicing. Common thing is that integration part. If you know all the formulas and conversion of the integration, you can easily solve the problem within a 5 minutes. 5 marks question means you have to complete within a 5 minutes. Okay. So this is all. You have to solve the problem.
Yes. Third point. X square into d by dx is equal to x square minus 2y square plus x square. Okay. First of all, we need to prove it is a homogeneous function. How to show it is a homogeneous function? That means, first of all, we have to get the f of x, y. Divided by dx coefficient should be 1. Divided by dx is equal to x square minus 2y square plus xy divided by x square square. So, how will we do? We can take the. Okay, I just write or let consider f of x, y. What is the f of x, y? F of x, y as x square minus 2y square plus x into y divided by x square. This is our f of x, y. Now replace the x as lambda x, y as the lambda y to check the homogeneous. Wherever x is there, lambda x. So lambda x square minus 2. Lambda square, y square plus lambda x, lambda y. Lambda, lambda. Lambda square x into y divided by here lambda square into x square. Are you okay? Now lambda square, lambda square, lambda square. Numerator 3 terms are there. Out of the 3 terms, lambda square is common. Remaining being x square minus 2 into y square plus x into y. Whole thing divided by lambda square into x square. Are you sure? Now lambda square get cancelled. Again it is left in the form of f of x comma y into lambda power 0. Lambda power 0, f of x comma y. Is it f of x comma y? Yes, obviously. So we just got lambda f of x comma lambda y as lambda power 0 into f of x comma y. Therefore, f of x comma y, f of x comma y is a homogeneous function. Is a homogeneous function. Compulsory have to mention because they given that show that the given function is homogeneous. After that homogeneous, we need to solve the equation. How to solve? For solution, I just need a much space so that reason and just rough this homogeneous. So you can pause video, try to solve it. Okay. So here it is a f of x from y. Now, I just take in the dy by dx formula. So, what is the common? I just take the x square is common. If you take an x square is common, what we get? It is 1 minus 2 into y square divided by x square plus already 1 x is there, so it is sufficient to write the y by x divided by x square. Here, x square give the answer x power 0 into g of y form will get. Okay, now here. So put y by x is equal to, if you replace the y by x as p, then y is equal to x into p. Every problem has the same steps are there, nothing to worry. Differentiating with respect to x now, without referring the previous problem. Just try to solve up to the end of the problem. If you have struck in between, just think over it, hardly the 5 to 10 seconds. If you are not getting the next shot, then just go for the previous problem as a reference. Just see that step where you have just struck, then proceed. Okay, now differentiating dy by dx is equal to product root differentiation of x with respect to x is 1 into p as it is plus x into dv by dx. Call this as equation number 2 and this is the, or else this is the equation number 1. Every problem has the same. Now put equation number 2 in 1. Dy by dx is replaced as this much. What is p plus x into dv by dx is equal to 1 minus 2 into p square plus p. Are you sure? Now here simplify. After replacing this equation number 2 into 1, simplify. plus V plus V get cancelled. What is left? X into dV1 dx is equal to 1 minus 2 V square. After simplification, this is the maximum simplification we can do. After simplification, variables of Weber method. Variables of Weber method as is continue, or else this is taken into your friends and 1 by 1 minus 2 into V square into dV is equal to 1 by x into dx. I have already told you that right hand side in the homogeneous function always leads us to the 1 by x into dx. Okay, only the left hand side term will be changes. Now integrating. So for integrating, I just eliminate this negative quantity because better to keep the positive, will get the easily. Multiplying root by negative. What happens? 1 divided by 2 t square minus 1 into dv is equal to minus 1 by x into dx. Right hand side there is no problem, you can easily integrate. Left hand side, how to integrate the 2 v square minus 1? 2 v square minus 1 into dv is that. Here integration part is that 2 v square minus 1. How can you integrate v square minus 1? You can take the 1 by 2 is outside. 1 by 2 if you take an outside means v square minus 1 by 2 into dv is equal to minus 1 by x into dx. Now we can make that proper square. 1 by 2 into. So 1 by p square minus 1 by root 2 whole square into dv is equal to minus 1 by x into dx integration. Now which is of the form? 1 divided by x square minus a square. What is the integration of 1 divided by x square minus a square? So I just better write the formula here. Integration of 1 divided by x square minus a square into dx is equal to how much? 1 by 3 into log of mod of x minus a divided by x plus a plus c. Do you know this formula? Okay, 6 formulas are there. 1 divided by x square minus a square, 1 divided by x square plus a square, 1 divided by a square minus x square. This is outside the room. Again, 1 divided by root of x square minus a square, x square plus a square under the root, a square minus x square under the root. All the 6 formulas are there. You have to remember with along with the proofs. Okay, because proofs are very important for the examination. They used to ask that, prove that and solve based on that same formula. They will ask the question. Okay, using this formula, what we get in place of x, p in place of e, 1 divided by root 2 is that. Okay. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into a, 2 into a value is what? 1 divided by root 2. Okay, 1 by 2 into log of x minus a, that means p minus 1 by root 2 divided by p plus 1 by root 2 plus c. I just write on the right hand side plus c. Are you clear? Now simplify. How to simplify? Here root 2 is come to the numerator, root 2 is a 4, or is 2 into root 2, but right root 2 come to the numerator, 1 divided by 2 into 2, 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2, one of the root 2 get cancelled. Okay, log of p minus or root 2 into p, root 2 into p minus 1, root 2 into p plus 1, root 2 root 2 get cancelled is equal to minus log of mod of x plus c. Okay, here 1 divided by 2 into root 2 is left into log. Replace the p. What is the p? P is nothing but y by x is that. So root 2 into y by x minus 1 divided by root 2 into y by x plus 1 is equal to minus log of mod of x plus c. I just continue on the right hand side.
Okay, just take a LCM and simplify
in the log value. Here I just take the LCM, 1 by 2 into root 2 log of x is LCM, root 2 into y minus x, root 2 into y plus x divided by x will cancel, plus log of mod x is equal to c minus log x as is taken left hand side. Now we can take the power or not necessary, keep as is. This much is the required solution. This is the general solution of the given differential equation. Are you clear? So this is how we have to solve the problems based on the homogeneous function. Okay, now seventh problem, x into cos of y by x plus y sine of y by x into this whole term into y by x is equal to y sine of y by x minus x into cos of y by x, this whole term into x into dy. We need to prove it is show that we need to show that it is a homogeneous and we need to solve it. Y by x is that there is thing which is called, we have to get the dy by dx. Okay, dy by dx is that dy, we need to get the numerator dy is that. Take this all term into left hand side, shift this all term, this dx into right hand side. What happens? Dx is goes, take this all terms into left hand side. This is as it is, x into cos of y by x plus y into sin of y by x, this thing into y is the whole thing divided by this is log bracket and x taken to left hand side. As this write x at the end, log bracket value, what is the log bracket value? Y into sin of y by x minus x into cos of y by x. Okay, now so this is the f of x comma y, or else again here y by x you can write numerator, so dy by dx is equal, again you can rewrite. How to rewrite means here I just take the x is common, I just take the x is common in this plot bracket. What happens? Cos of y by x as it is plus x is common, here y is there, x is not there, y by x into sine of y by x, log bracket complete, into this divided by x taken to the numerator, whole thing divided by again in the denominator, this x already is taken to the numerator, again I just take the x is common into log bracket, here only y is the y by x into sine of y by x, from the angle will not take anything common, so keep as it is, x is already common, so cos of y by x. Okay, into x I have written here, x x can cancel, this is the f of x common, so dy by dx is equal to this much, so let f of x comma y is equal, what is that? Cos of y by x plus y by x into sin of y by x, whole thing divided by or this thing into or plug bracket, log bracket into y by x, denominator y by x into sin of y by x. Very simple problem, but terms are not that thing, only difference. Now this is the f of x power, already if you sum the form x power 0 into g of y by x, check it, second method to check the homogeneous. Okay, so this is whole term is the g of x, x over 0, this is the f of x comma y. So directly you can say that therefore the given function f of x comma y is homogeneous, is homogeneous. No, not necessary to replace the x as a lambda x, y as a lambda y in this problem, because directly they are given a y by x form, so that directly use this definition, or else you can replace it. Once again, you get the same thing, lambda power 0 into f of x comma y, nothing to worry. Okay, now I need to solve this differential equation. So how do you solve? So again the same thing, this value I just call it as the equation number 1. So in the equation number 1, I just rub this part, this part also I just rub it in the solution, it is needed. So due to the short of the, due to the small space, I am just rubbing. Okay, now I need to solve this differential equation. For that, I am just going to do the substitution. Put y by x is equal to p. If you replace y by x as p, what will get? Differentiating, or y is equal to x into p. Process is as usual, differentiating. Dy by dx is equal to p plus x into dv by dx. How it comes? Already know that differentiating this one with respect to x. So replacing this into here, p plus x into dv by dx is equal to. So cos of y by x as the p plus y by x as the p into sin of phi divided by phi into sin of phi minus cos of phi into y by x is that into phi. Are you clear? Then don't cancel the pv. Okay, here I just continue. Okay, how do you solve this one? Sit the p into right hand side. X into dv by dx is equal to, I just write the p at the first, cos of p plus p into sin of p divided by p into sin of p minus cos of p. This plus p is shifted into right hand side. Okay, now plus p is shifted into right hand side. Now take LCM, usual process. So x into dv by dx is equal to, this p into the bracket is that, keep as this, p into the bracket, cos of p plus p into sin of p and minus p times of this bracket is that. So better to multiply the p. P into this bracket, what we get? P into cos p. Phi into phi, phi square into sin of phi. Okay, here minus phi is that. LCM term is this one, phi sin phi minus cos phi. Phi into minus phi into this bracket. What happens? Minus phi square into sin phi minus minus plus phi into cos of phi. This whole thing divided by phi into sin of phi minus cos of phi. Now check it. What are the term get cancer? What are the term get reduces? Check it and just simplify the things. What will get cancer? Plus p square sin p minus p square sin p get cancer. Remaining term p cos p plus p cos p. That means 2 times of p cos p divided by p sin of p minus cos of left hand side x into d by dx. Okay, now separate the variable, simplify. Here I just take that p into sin p minus cos of p divided by, that is 2 into p cos of p is equal to 1 by x into dx. Always same thing, 1 by x into dx, integration on this thing. So how to integrate this one? P sin p minus cos p divided by 2p into cos p. Better to keep the 2 on right hand side only. Better to keep the 2 on the right hand side only. Okay. Now how to integrate this one? Right hand side integration you can easily do it. Left hand side. Separate the term. This sum divided by this. This by this integration. P we get cancelled. Sin p divided by cos p can be written as tan of p minus cos v divided by integration into dv minus cos cos will cancel, integration of 1 divided by p into dv is equal to 2 into 1 by x into dx. And to play with this term, separate the term and simplify. V v get cancelled, sin bar cos is tan p into dv. Here it is dv is this. And cos cos will cancel, minus term 1 by p is left. Okay. What is the integration of tan x? Do you know the integration of tan x? Yes, log of mod of sec x is that. So integration of tan x with respect to x is log sec x. Okay. Next, 1 by v integration, we know that. Okay, all the term integration we know that. This we can write log of mod of sec of v minus log of mod v is equal to 2 into log of mod of x plus c. That's it. So log m minus log n, log m minus log n is log of m by m, sec p divided by p is equal to log of mod of x square plus c. So again replacing the, again you can write log of, take this term into left hand side, log of mod of sec t divided by t minus log of mod of x square is equal to c. Log n minus log n. What is the log n minus log n? Log n minus log n is nothing but log of m by n. Log of sec of t divided by b divided by x square is that is denominator into x square is equal to c. After writing it is equal to c. Yes. Now specify that. Now replace the p, or that we can write sec p divided by p into x square is equal to e power c. So here I just write this as c1 e power c1. So replace the p, or p into x square is equal to c, where c is equal to e power c1 integration function. What is the p? P is a y by x. So sec of y by x divided by y by x into x square is equal to c. So sec of y by x divided by one of the x will cancel, x into y is equal to c. So this is the required solution of the given differential equation. So this is how we have to solve the problem. So very simple thing, each and every problem has the same thing, but only the f of x comma y is going to change. So dependent on the f of x comma y, we have to solve the problem. So practice all the problem up to the 7th problem. Previous all the 3-4 problems I just left it. Solve all the problems. Remaining problems will continue in the next video. Okay, thank you.